A while back, I put out a video where I showed you 5 ways to get smooth playback in DaVinci Resolve. I'll link that below in case you missed it. Unfortunately, some people said that even when they tried all 5 tips, they were still getting choppy playback when trying to edit their videos. So I'm back with 3 more tips for you to try in order to fix that. Cool? Let's get started. The first tip I have is to use Render Cache Color Output. This will pre-render your footage even if you haven't color graded it yet, which should make your playback smoother, kind of like when you render your Fusion clips. It makes them able to play back smoother. Rendering color cache is easy. Just select the clip or clips that you want to render. By the way, that would be basically all of them. Right click and select Render Cache Color Output. Now, there are some upsides and downsides to rendering your color cache output. The upside is that in most cases, you should receive much faster playback in DaVinci Resolve. The downside is that it takes a while to render. And when I say a while, I mean go ahead and set this up and then go grab yourself a coffee, do some laundry, and watch an episode of The Office because your computer's gonna be held hostage for a while. And on top of that, every time you make a change to your footage, the rendering process will start over for that clip. This is why I left it off of the original video. Still, if you've exhausted all of your other options, Render Color Cache Output should give you the results you're looking for. The second method is to simply switch up your editing drive. Let me explain. Most laptops and even a lot of pre-built desktop computers come with one hard drive, and that hard drive is expected to house all of your software, photos, videos, and unless you're using an external drive, all of the footage that you're editing. This can understandably bog down the drive and make it slower, resulting in choppy playback. The solution to this is to use a drive that is dedicated to housing all of the footage for your active projects. And when I say dedicated, I mean dedicated. Nothing else should live on that drive except for footage and other assets that you use to make your videos. Now, ideally, this drive would be an internal SSD, but if you're using a computer with only one hard drive, even an external SSD would be better than bogging down your system by adding even more stuff to your main hard drive. By the way, this goes for not only DaVinci Resolve, but all NLEs. So any of you Premiere Pro users watching this, you're welcome. My third tip is to actually convert your footage to a different file type. Here's the thing, H.264, which is the type of video that most consumer level cameras, even smartphones, export are not made for editing. They're highly compressed, and that makes it harder to work with in post. Some cameras have even started shooting in H.265, which is even harder to edit. That's right, Canon. I'm looking at you. So what are the best video file types to use for editing? The best that I've found is RAW, especially Blackmagic RAW. B-RAW in DaVinci Resolve is just magic. More on that in a later video. But DNHR, DNHD, and ProRes all work well too. Okay, I know what you're thinking. But Jay, my camera only shoots H.264. Don't worry, I've got you covered. There are a few different ways to actually convert your H.264 footage to DNHR, DNHD, or ProRes in DaVinci Resolve. One way, probably the easiest way, is to generate optimized media, which we covered in my last video on this topic. Again, linked below. Then there's a really cool trick that you can use with DaVinci Resolve's built-in media encoder. I don't personally have a video on that, but my friend Billy does. I'll link that below. But the best way that I've found, and I'll explain why in a second, is to simply bring the footage into a timeline, head over to the deliver page, choose your settings, and render your files. The reason why I think this is the best way to do it comes down to one very special feature in DaVinci Resolve. That feature is Superscale. Here's why. Let's say you've got a whole bunch of 1080p footage, but you need to put it in a 4K project. What you can do is add Superscale to the H.264 footage, and then export the footage as, say, a DNHR 444 10-bit file, and then when you bring that footage back into Resolve to edit, you'll be working with a 4K file that's optimized for editing instead of a highly compressed 1080p file that is horrible for editing. And before you jump down my throat for not showing you how to use Superscale, I've already made a video on it. You can check that out right here. And for more tools, tips, and tricks that will make you a better video editor, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.